Join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. I am Michelle Small. And I would like to open the public hearing for the town of Rollinsburg at 9 a.m. on February 10, 2018. The purpose is any public comment on the proposed town and water and sewer budget. I'll introduce the board, just in case you don't know, who our board is, how deep from my list rather than my time to speak. I'm Michelle Small, the chair. Denise Knowles is vice chair. Bill Irving, Vern Crozier, Andy Gale, Nancy Dion, Charlie Dion, Ted Jansen, Kim St. Hilaire, ex officio Suzanne McEwers for the town's wet board, Dennis St. Hilaire, officio for the water and sewer, and Judy Nelson, ex officio for the school board. Before we start, I just want to set some ground rules. It is a public hearing, which is the opportunity for you to provide comment to the budget committee. I would like you to ask your questions to myself rather than getting into any banter with the committee. Our committee won't be asking questions. If they want to speak as an individual, they will go up to the mic in the middle just as any of you would. When you do go to the mic, please state your name and address. And please don't crowd somebody who's speaking if you would just stand back a bit so that they have plenty of room. Keep the comments relevant to what the budget is, which I hope everybody picked up the flyers up front. The most important thing is what I would hope everybody will remember. I've been on this committee for, I think, 15 years. And we are all neighbors. We all live next to each other and meet each other in public places. We're a community. And I'd like people to remember that a democracy is a difference of opinion. That's what makes it interesting. But you're still neighbors. And at the end of the day, I would hope that everybody leaves with the feeling of respect that they were allowed to say what they felt and that they were heard. So with that, I'd like to open with the town budget, which Suzanne Ward will present, and we will give a brief overview, and then we can take any comments.
Thank you, Michelle. Good morning, everybody. Bookkeeping, housekeeping issues. One, there's a lot of material out there. There's more material on the website before we started to read some things. We had a report yesterday with the link, so with that link, you'll be able to go to some folders, and you will be adding materials from now through town meetings to those folders. So go back and take a look at them for the next couple of weeks. Also, what we're discussing this morning will be budget-related items, the operating budget and all the warrants that have appropriations. But there are two warrants that, while they don't have appropriations, we are required by state law to hold public hearings on them. So I'm going to announce to you when those are. So on Monday, this coming Monday, at 6 o'clock, we will be holding a public hearing at Town Hall on the article with regard to authorizing PIMO in the municipality of Rollinsburg. Monday at 6 o'clock. And then on Tuesday the 20th, so the following week, we will be hosting a public hearing at Town Hall at 6 o'clock on a petition warrant article to question whether we want to become an SB2 municipality. Okay. Last one, the operating budget. So we're going to be looking at the entire budget. So that includes the operating budget, which is recommended by the budget committee, and then all the warrants that have appropriations. And while the budget committee cannot change those warrants, they can review and choose to recommend or not recommend. And those recommendations show up on the town warrant. So here's an overall summary. With the three revenues, anticipated revenues, we have a growing assessed valuation, even beyond the faculty and the value. And together, all of that plus our expenditures and the appropriations that are being proposed today, with all of that, we are estimating really hold steady on the municipal part of our tax effort and tax rate. So we're actually looking right now at a small decrease of about $5,000 in the overall tax effort, which is about a negative 2 cents in the tax rate. So let's say hold steady. Here are the highlights of the proposed budget committee operating budget. There are some quite structural changes that are put in by the board, the select board, who manage the budget and final analysis. And so they are, we collected for privacy reasons that health insurance premiums and other life and disability premiums into personnel administration. So that you can see the comparison, if you look at that, because we collected all the expenses for last year as well. And you will find the health premiums, that there was a 6.1% decrease, surprisingly, in our health premiums. The line has been increased by a few $100 because we have an additional staff member who is out on it. But we were very pleased to see that 6.1% decrease. We also consolidated, we have lines down for full-time staff and part-time staff. That's most notable in the police department and the highway department. Those salaries have already been consolidated for a number of years in the transfer station section and the fire department. But in order to provide the town with information on what our staff, our employees earn, we have a new report, right? John, is it out there? It's out there, it's called Salaries and Wages or Earnings Report or something like that. So by position, so you know, 20 firefighters, 30 firefighters, you can see what they have earned throughout the course of 2017. Police chief, fire chief, he's an elected official, he's just employed. So police chief, lieutenant, sergeant, and the like. This year, there's one area that's in between the board and the budget committee. The budget committee elected to reduce the operating budget by $250,000 with the guidance that comes from the road maintenance line. Their objective was to, not as a budget committee because they can't, but outside of the budget committee, put together a petition warrant article to have one for $250,000 for road budget. The town attorney Roberts is here today to give the assembly and the budget committee some legal guidance on that issue. So that will come up immediately after my presentation. All right, some other changes. We now have debt because we were authorized by last year's town meeting to go out and borrow money for culverts, the fire engine, and the transportation improvements. If you recall, we were projecting that debt service to start out at $110,000 per year. We are really delighted to say that our debt service starts at just under $80,000 per year. For two reasons. We have some advantageous terms, and we've got a handout out back on what those terms are and the repayment schedule. And also, we ended up not having to borrow quite so much. So we got a grant from the Hampshire Department of Environmental Services by the USEPA for $110,000 for the fire engine. So that was a big help. And we ended up not spending quite so much on the COVID project. Compensation increases. So we are giving at least 2% across the board to staff. Additionally, we are giving, we added 3% to the Rollinsford Police salary base, not to individuals, but to the salary base. And what will happen is that this year, the chief will make recommendations of salary increases to police staff based on merit. So we don't yet know what they will be, but he's got, you know, 3% increase of the salary base to work with. There's also a large increase percentage-wise. It's only a couple thousand dollars, but percentage-wise to the fire department salaries line. These are our on-call folks who have been making pretty much, it's not really an hourly rate. They have a formula that they use, but it turns out to be pretty much close to, or not much more than minimum wage. And so she brought her into us and said, we're really having trouble with maintaining on-call firefighters, and he recommended that we increase that one, which we did. We actually increased it by maybe $1,000 more than he was suggesting. And we are planning in this upcoming year to appoint a committee to look at on-call fire service and how we can best maintain, particularly for day coverage. We highlighted in the select board's annual report, which you'll see in the town meeting, and our fire chief has also, I think, spoken about it in his annual report. You might want to get more information on that. In personnel administration, as I've already said, consolidated, you'll see there all of our health premiums and other insurance premiums. And I've already said that we've had a small decrease, so am I going backwards? No. In buildings and facilities, what we hope to do with the town hall budget line is to paint and repair the portico that the town hall recently noticed. It really needs those columns are starting to rot, so it needs some work. We are hoping to demolish the shed, the old timey shed on Silver Street. We've actually paid for it out of 2017 funds thanks to the police department's savings in the budget lines. But there is an expense in FY18 for, you ready for it? Asbestos abatement. So there's some asbestos in that building. You're going to have to pay to have it abated and removed, you know, by certified removers. So that'll cost us about $2,000. And the fire department has been, you know, we increased their budget for maintenance a little bit last year. We're continuing with that increase this year. They have been kind of marching forward trying to make some needed upgrades to the fire department, right? New flooring, some painting, some plumbing, some heating, all of those kinds of things. Highway department. So there's a lot to say here in the highway department. There have been some large changes. As you know, our road agent, I think 7 years, was signed as of September 1. I suppose there's no good time of year for your road agent to leave, but with the approach of winter months, we were near panic mode about not having a road agent because we have no other full-time employee in the highway department. So we formulated a search committee, hired a road agent, and both the search committee and the road agent very strongly recommended that the board consider having a full-time highway department assistant. And so we did that in the fall. And so we now have a road agent, which we met, and a full-time highway department assistant at Walsh. And I think we're going to enjoy the results of both of those hires. Now, the board doesn't take lightly adding full-time staff. Full-time staff is expensive. There's no getting around it. You have to pay retirement, health insurance. So they are expensive, but again, it was very strongly recommended, and because we now have full-time staff, we will enjoy some savings in other lines. Will it be enough to offset the full-time hire? No, but there are other advantages to having two full-time employees. There's a real do-it-yourself philosophy with our new highway department. They're pragmatic problem solvers. One of them has a patent for equipment that he developed somewhere else. And we are going to see some savings. There will be, of course, a reduction of part-time and seasonal help because now both of our employees have rental driver's licenses, so we don't need as much seasonal help with the plumbing. We intend, if our warrant article for roadside mowing attachment passes, we intend to do our own roadside mowing, our own brush chipping, our own ditching, some small road repair, and some equipment fabrication. So, and possibly some street sweeping. So we're exploring all of those things. I think we're really pleased, and we hope that you will be pleased at some of the changes and improvements that you see in the town with our newly constituted highway department. Of course, I can't talk about highway department without talking about our roads. And you may remember that we developed a 10-year road plan last year with Stratford Regional Planning Commission. And, I'm sorry, 2 years ago. And in 2017, you know, we're going to upgrade this every year, but in 2017, when we were ready to upgrade our 10-year road plan, our road agents was on. So while we didn't update it, we are continuing to work on it. We will update it in the spring with our new road agent. But in the meantime, we're going to follow what the plan is. And so the next two items on the road plan are two developments, the Woodlands and Roberts Farm. So the Moses Carr Heritage Drive was run for the road. We plan to have a $300,000 contract, road contract. And we'll do all of one development and as much of the others we can fit into the $300,000 contract. And then whatever we don't finish, we will to do the following year. The transfer station, you'll see over 5% decrease overall in the transfer station. If you look at the municipal solid waste hauling line, there's a 25% decrease there, entirely to having a second compactor. I don't remember what the actual budgeted amount is for that line, but we didn't have as much experience with the second compactor in 2017 as we hoped, so it's possible that we will enjoy savings even above and beyond what we're putting in the budget. We'll just have to wait and see. As I said before, we're going to be doing our own brush chipping. And another item of note that really doesn't have a budgetary implication this year is that the board is considering leaving the truck hauling cooperative. This is a subset of the Rampart Regional Waste Cooperative that we belong to, so not thinking about leaving the waste cooperative. Just this little subset, there are five communities that bought a big truck, hired somebody to drive the truck, et cetera, et cetera. And we think that we can do better in the open market with, you know, from year to year getting contracts on hauling our municipal solid waste to the current landfill site. So we're exploring this. Removing ourselves in that cooperative. There's a 20% decrease in direct assistance or welfare. This is a little bit like special education in the school side, where, you know, we are required to take care of the poor in the town, and you don't really know what's going to happen from year to year. But one difference with school is that one special ed case, it costs, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars. That wouldn't be the case for us in direct assistance, but, you know, could we be putting ourselves into a bind by decreasing by 20%? Well, possibly, but we're careful. We've been watching over the last few years. Our administrative assistant has been managing this function for us since she came on board, and we have benefited from having one consistent approach to the application of direct assistance. And since she's been on board, we've had a persistent surplus in direct assistance. So we are recommending 20% increase. Recreation, this is a big number. There is a 70% increase. However, the revenue offsets over 97% of that budget, of the recreation budget. The Rec Committee, we're really delighted with the newly constituted Rec Committee. And last year was the first instance of Camp Raleigh. And this coming year, they're hoping to have a teen camp for teenagers. So the programs, those two programs, are entirely offset by revenue, and they constitute about 97% of the recreation budget. The other items in there, our winter basketball and fireworks for Family Fun Day. And the committee is hoping to do something with seniors, and so they may start out by just doing a survey of our seniors. So there's a line with a little bit of money for that. All right, so to sum the operating budget, which is one warrant article, we have increases to the operating budget, but there's offset by large increases in revenue. Some of those large increases are from increased detail work with the police department, and detail work brings in more than what the expense is. So actually, as you know, as the detail goes up, the record goes up, even if it's somewhat steeper. The REC programs, of course, are offset largely by revenue. And we get an additional almost $50,000 from the District of Transportation this year to fund road maintenance from, I think it's from the Volkswagen settlement. And we have new operators for the hydro plant, and they are projecting, we've been using $35,000 as our revenue budget. When they did their business plan to see whether it made sense for them to take over or bid on taking over the operations of the hydro plant, and the company's green on power, they were projecting $55,000 as revenue per year for the plan. So we, the board chose not to raise the revenue by that much, but we did raise it by $7,000. So the bottom line, again, I'm going to repeat this bottom line. If you look at what we're planning for the operating budget, for all of our capital expenditures, for all of our reserve fund proposed deposits, holding steady on the municipal tax rate reduction is 20%. That's the operating budget. Michelle, if you want to, just go on with the lines? Can we ask our town attorney to speak on that?
Very effective. Supreme Court rejected the attempt of voters to lock the selectmen into certain appropriated items by individual line item. There, the voters tried to say, here's a line item, you have to spend the money for that line item only, and the court said, no, that's not what RSA 3210 means. To the extent that there's unexpended balances, the Board of Selectmen has to have the flexibility and discretion to use that money. And then finally, Baker versus Hudson, that was a school district case, but the same thing. The Budget Committee deleted money from the school district budget with the hope that the voters at the school district meeting would add to it, and the Supreme Court said, you can't do that. If you know there's a legitimate need, the goal and the purpose and the whole function of the Budget Committee is to provide the operating budget, to put the money into the operating budget for that need, and you cannot by subterfuge, that was the word used by the Supreme Court, try to change both the role of the Budget Committee and the role of the selectmen, or in that case, the school district. So it's very clear under the statute, and it's very clear under the case law that to the extent that there's an operating budget item, that money should be in the operating budget. It should not be in a capital budget. It should not be a capital reserve fund. And my understanding of the road maintenance is its maintenance is prepared. So that's an operating item. That's not a capital item. And so by transferring the money, there's any dispute about the need for the money. I think even the Budget Committee realizes there's a need for the money. By moving the money from the operating budget, it would be voted on by town meeting and then implemented by the Board of Selectmen. By moving the money from the operating budget to a petition warrant article, you're essentially restricting, limiting, eliminating the flexibility of the Board of Selectmen, which under the three cases I have decided would not be appropriate. And I guess the question, Madam Chairman, which I'll direct to you, would be, what is the intent of this switch? You know, what is the Budget Committee trying to achieve by doing this? To the extent that there's any challenge of this particular action, that would be something that a reviewing court would ask that question.
And I'll allow anybody here to jump in as well for the... I was asked a question, so I would like to answer it. Thank you. The discussion that was held during the budget meeting, and my understanding was that the amount of that budget line was felt that it was high enough that it should be in its own warrant article versus inside the operating budget. I don't know if anybody here is disagreeing with that statement.
I was just going to say that my understanding of our discussion was it was more of a philosophical difference in terms of who gets to decide where the money is. Should it be a decision made by the select board, or should it be made by the legislative body? Again, I don't think there was a question the money's needed. It's how is it to be used? And that was, in effect, the crux of the reason it was done. And that's my understanding of it. I don't know if anybody else has a different view on it.
My position as a Budget Committee member was that having it in the warrant article is the only way to control it, that those dollars go toward our roads. Once it goes into the operating budget, you heard from Attorney Charles
It's on. I concur with Attorney Roberts regarding the fact that the Supreme Court has said within the operating budget, the selectmen may move the money around between line items however they wish. The concern as a private citizen, and I was the one that instigated this Warren article, was we want this money spent on roads exclusively. That was the intent, that was the purpose. I'm not suggesting they would do some shenanigans with this money if it were in the operating budget, but by putting it into a Warren article, I guarantee you by state law, they have to spend it on roads. It can't be used for any other purpose. Now, I talked to DRA yesterday, and they basically said, what's the big deal? You're going to repair your roads. You're just guaranteeing that that $250,000 will be used on roads. What's the big deal? It has a no fault, no harm action. That's why.
So, if I'm understanding this correctly, if this warrant isn't passed, what happens?
There's not $250,000 for roads.
Okay, so, in essence, if the $250,000 is in the operating budget instead of this, and the budget passes, the money is available, there isn't any concern that we're going to be just waiting for March to figure out whether or not we have this money. If it's voted in the budget, it'll be there.
Correct.
Okay.
It is not in the budget at this time.
Right. I really don't understand how this is even necessary. If this is what your concern is, then I'm not clear why we have any operating budget. Why don't we have everything that is dealt with by the select board, which we all elect. We elect the select board to do this job, to make sure that things are being paid for as they come along. I'm getting the impression, and maybe I'm overstepping this, but I'm getting the impression that the folks that put this together do not trust the select board. And if that's the case, there's no other reason you would do this. I didn't hear anything until this that indicated we were having a problem with our select board appropriating funds correctly. This is the first I've heard of this. So this is really, it's concerning. It makes me wonder, well, is there something else going on here that I'm not aware of? If there's something else with the budget, if there's some fuzzy math or something that just didn't add up, right? This makes no sense to me. This budget, this warrant, as you're suggesting, if it fails, then that's $250,000 that we may need, we're going to have to figure out somewhere else to get it from. Is that not correct? Is that not a correct statement?
That is a correct statement if there were to be, yes.
Of items to the operating budget from which farm labor and
least for me, and I think for some others, is to understand when change occurs, what's the justification for it. And if I understand Steve's interpretation, if the selectman said it'd be one way, it'd be another way. If I were a selectman again, and I said, well, maybe all the capital items for roads and bridges for more than 2 years or 1 year, whatever, would be capital, it would revert back. So that it depends upon the decisions of the existing board of selectmen. And if we go back to where it's been done now, then your solution to that would change the composition of the board of selectmen as you need more capital to search it. And it's all boils down to why capital. When you put it in the operating, all our things in the operating budget, the selectmen, if you go out and negotiate the roads, and they tell you you got authorization for $250,000, but it's going to cost $275,000, you need to pay the $275,000 or you need to repair part of the road. So, but now, with the operating budget, they can, if they can find it elsewhere, you can go ahead and pay the $275,000 for the same road this year. Because you just transfer it from somewhere else in the budget. So it does have something to do with the situation.
Try to answer Mr. Jansen's question. We found no state statutes that told us that we could not budget for road maintenance in the operating budget. And we're not taking some leap to the great unknown. We've been talking about doing this over the last 3 years. We've been steadily increasing the amount of maintenance budget and been saying that we are moving towards putting all of road maintenance within the operating budget. So this is the year we did it. No, we heard nothing from either groups, town meetings, or people who have come to the select board meetings to say that they objected to that. We looked around. Again, we're not on the bleeding edge. Certain municipalities will put all of their money in the road. But from a town perspective, the towns of New Durham, Farmington, Barrington, Lee provide for all of their road work. Roping is within the operating budget. So we don't feel that we're on the bleeding edge. We look around when we make changes like this to see what other towns do and how they manage them. As I've already said, the contract is probably going to be $300,000. So the road maintenance petition warrant doesn't cover that, so we're going to have to go back to the operating budget. And from a budgetary and accounting perspective, It streamlines the process to have the bath within your operating budget. So, you know, we've got $325,000, $300,000 will be used for a contract, and more if the contract turns out to be more, and then the remainder will cover some other road maintenance projects around the town. Thanks, Mr. Chairman. So going forward for projections, for ease of understanding how it works things, you've got things in a couple of different places. And again, we were not proposing anything. We were surprised because we were not proposing anything that seemed out of the ordinary. The towns of New Durham, Barrington, Lee, Farmington, and I'm sure many others, those are the ones that we checked, have all the road work within the operating budget. Are there still some towns that don't? Yes. I think Madbury is one. I don't know of others, but I believe Madbury is one. So, but the fact that there's only $250,000 in the program, I mean, if it passes, then our contract would be funded by the road board as well as by the operating budget.
I want to be sure that our road budget is funded, and I don't want to vote for something that feels counter to a process that, as a voter last year, I set in motion, which is trusting the select board to act on my behalf and my best interest. So my question is more for Attorney Roberts than for the budget committee, and that is, if as we address this difference of opinion and this challenge as a voter that I face, what does it mean for the long term of the town in managing our budget in this way through warrant articles? I don't know that I can even conform a better question on that, because I'm very confused about the process and about trust. And so what does it mean in the long term? This year, I have to support something that helps the town. But in the long term, do I want to do this every year is my question. How does this shape up for a long-term process for the town? If you could help with that, and where we might end up legally in the long term.
I think the best way to answer that is that if this line item appropriation were to be allowed to be put in front of the voters and was adopted, it could create a precedent that other items would be pulled out of the operating budget and put into a special warrant article to the point where then the Board of Selectmen would be almost superfluous, because then the town meeting would have decided every item down to some salary, I suppose, if you really want to go out to and serve, to be served. So the concern, I think, as expressed by the Hampshire Supreme Court and as expressed by me, is that by starting down this path of taking away the discretion and flexibility of the Board of Selectmen, you're creating a precedent that potentially has a win to where then the budget committee or any 25 people, because that's how we petition warrant, any 25 people can do that. It's ultimately up to the town meeting, it's up to the legislative body to determine that, whether or not they want to go along with that process, but that's the concern.
Is, in my view, an operational item. It's not a new road, it's not a new building, it's maintenance, it's operation, it belongs in the operating budget. We elect a select board to manage the town. We cannot continue to handcuff them and tie them and say this, that, or the next thing. The remedy for shenanigans by the select board is to vote them out of office. We put them there, we want them to run the budget, we give them the money. If they don't, we throw them out of office. It's pretty simple, but we can't handcuff them. This money should be in the operating budget, and we should allow the town officials to do their job. Thank you. Way around it at town meeting, where you would amend the warrant article
operating budget and add back in the $250,000. So, but that's the machination you would have to do as opposed to putting it into the operating budget as it was originally proposed. So I just want to clarify that.
Okay. Year to carry over to the next year budget. I that's the position that we've now made full time. So the other part-time salaries are the plow drivers. We have someone who has been amazingly helpful to the town, who does equipment fabrication, welding, and other kinds of things for us. So that's all included in the budget for part-time positions in the highway department.
And in 2017, I believe, when the budget was passed, there was an increase in legal fees on the town side. We didn't see as much need for legal. Is that remaining true going forward? Or is it remaining steady?
Well, we're off to a running start, aren't we? I believe there's a decrease in professional services, which is both legal and engineering generally. And so I don't remember the issues 2 years ago. There were some. Last 2017, we built the budget knowing that we needed bond counsel for our loan applications. We have, you know, we're renegotiating a Comcast franchise agreement. We were buying and selling some property. We were working on finalizing the boundaries between Dover and Oak Street, between Dover and Rollinsford and along Oak Street. So there have been a number of issues. We've slowly been pecking away at them. There was an issue with land that we owned in Berwick that we resolved with Mr. Fogarty. So there have been a number of issues that we have built a budget up so we could start to peck away at these things. And so we did, and we've been successful. There's still some ongoing that we haven't completed. But because of that, I don't know what the figure is, but we did recommend increase overall.
Thank you.
Questions?
I just have a final question going back to this. This would be the issue around the warrant article and the budget and the roads.
Could you say your name?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, we're having a slide over.
Thank you.
So as I remember, as some people have also stated, that in the past we have had warrant articles for the roads separate from the budget, and that has been deemed appropriate. So what I'm trying to understand, and just to make sure I have it right, I'm going to go through, maybe have the same question, is that because this year it was put into the budget, that is what then would make it illegal to pull it out of the budget at this point, or that it would be, could be challenged legally to pull it out of the budget at this point? Exactly. Is that where the song is lying here? Or do I have it totally wrong?
Council, would you like me to take a stand with this? In essence, yes. So again, from a background point of view, the board has been talking about for a number of years slowly increasing the putting road maintenance in the operating budget with a decrease in the road warrant article, with the final result of having it all be in the operating budget. Again, we're not doing anything that's bleeding edge. Take a look at the budgets of Farmington, New Durham, Barrington, and Lee. And I'm sure a lot of others as well. But once the board, the select board, the governing body, has determined that it feels that the road maintenance should be within the operating budget, to have a budget committee, which is my understanding of what happened, the budget committee decided it didn't care for that, like it, whatever, all the reasons that they stated, then they were able to pull it out and then, oh, by the way, insert, get a petition warrant article in there. So could a budget committee then in the future do the same thing for, I don't know, police salaries or anything that's currently in the operating budget? I think that that's the precedent, and that's the issue, is that the budget committee knew it couldn't do it as a budget committee, it's still trying to engineer the same thing by reducing the budget and going out and putting in a petition on it. And the same thing theoretically could happen with any item that the board chooses to put in the operating budget.
Great, thanks. That clarifies it for me. So as a citizen, it sounds to me like for this year, we need to leave this money should be in the budget, and so I would encourage the budget committee to put that money back in the budget. And it sounds like if there's concern going forward with this, then another year pressure should be put on the select board to take that out if that's what people feel is appropriate. So I'm not going to get into the future, but just for right now, I would encourage the budget committee to please put this money back in the budget. I'm worried about battles or Nancy Daniel Rollins Road. Is it your interpretation that the budget committee put out the warrant, or it was private citizens that put out the warrant for the $250,000?
I'd be happy to answer that question.
At the 3 minutes, look at the video. At the budget committee meeting, the budget committee members who wanted to do this said that they were going to put together a petition warrant article to ask citizens, that they were members of the budget committee, saying that that's what they were going to do. At the end of the meeting, right after the adjournment, Mr. Crozier had the petition warrant article, went around getting signatures from those budget committee members who voted to do this.
Correct. So that we actually did it as private citizens, we didn't do it as a budget committee. So the warrant article is not represented by the budget committee.
Do we have any other public comment? Charlie?
Charles Tuckman, 85 Sligo Road. I'm speaking as the town moderator, and I will moderate as best as I can a fair, open, impartial town meeting from the presiding point. I do think it's important to correct a misstatement about the ability to amend the operating budget if this particular warrant article would be voted down. In every one of the town meetings that I've been to in the last several years, there's a concerted effort by a group of people, it takes five people to get a secret ballot on any warrant article. And in pretty much every single monetary budget or monetary warrant article, there's been a secret ballot up or down on the full amount of the amount that was requested in the petition article. So if Attorney Roberts is right, that you vote down a capital budget item, that indicates the will of the body not to appropriate any money for that budget item, not for that purpose. So I will not be able to entertain a motion to reopen the operating budget at that time, as I understand Attorney Roberts' guidance.
Yeah.
There's a discussion about precedence and us changing kind of precedence of how money is appropriated via operating budget versus warrant articles. So the precedent has been that road resurfacing money has been primarily warrant articles for at least the last 8 years. And maybe Mr. Jansen can tell us how long that's been precedent. And just a follow-up about bringing forward the operating budget consideration. So as I understand it, wouldn't it only be if something motion do not bring it forward for consideration, that it would not be an issue? The question for the scenario that, oh, it's very easy to just go back in and amend the operating budget is
close at 250, and then the warrant article at a later time would be dropped to the dollar.
To the dollar. That would achieve the purpose that could otherwise be achieved if the budget committee were to adopt the operating budget, including the $250,000. We're still, the warrant article is still there. It'll still be presented to the town meeting, but they'd have to get an explanation to the select board and the budget committee as to what the concern is.
Thank you.
That raises another concern that I'm going to cue out. Use the microphone.
Is this on?
Yeah.
In hearing more specification, I'm a little concerned that we can't even at town meeting increase the operating budget by $250,000 because it is higher than 10%. So that's another concern. I think it's something that we have to address here. We have a lot of good conversation that we need to kind of move on, but I think it's something we have to address here as a budget committee now before we go to town meeting. But just bring that up.
The 10% includes all capital reserve funds, all special warrant articles. So the 10% isn't just the $1,950,000. You have to add up to all of them.
Okay. Lorraine?
You're right, Nancy Watson. Given the discussion today, I really urge the budget committee to take into consideration and vote that $250,000 back in. It avoids a lot of legal problems. It's just simpler and it makes the most sense. I urge you to trust our select board. They've worked for months on these budgets. I think that it's only fair that we respect them. And I respect the work that the budget committee has been doing, but I think you all need to understand this is opening a can of worms we do not need. Thank you.
Any other comment?
In hearing some of the discussion since I last spoke, honestly, I have absolutely no idea why we would ever want this kind of confusion. This really, the only thing I'm hearing is, it's just my opinion, the only thing I'm hearing is we do not trust our select board to use these funds appropriately. There's no other reason why we would have this. You know, to Mr. Irving's point earlier, if we have no trust, then we need to just open out of office. It's really that simple. This is just the most confusing, ridiculous thing I've ever heard. And when we're talking about, you know, things being closed during town meeting, just the process itself is so absolutely absurd. And you know, the fact that we have to have a lawyer here to explain this is just ridiculous. We're talking about any challenge to this is going to cost the town money. Now, who's going to appropriate that? Are we going to? And why don't we have a warrant article that we'll have to put up for the town to vote as to whether or not the select board can actually appropriate the funds to defend against something like this. This is what this is about. You're absolutely, Mr. Irving point again, you're handcuffing the select board. I see no evidence at all, any meeting I've ever gone to, that this is necessary. This is absolutely ridiculous. It's a waste of time, it's confusing to voters. The $250,000, whatever the amount is, if I'm hearing this correctly, this is not for a road project. This is for road maintenance. Why would that not be in the operating budget? I mean, if you're telling me we're going over to Smith Street and we're going to dig up the whole thing and we've got quotes and all that, okay, that's fine. This is for road maintenance. So are we going to make it so that if this doesn't pass, which, you know, I'm hearing things like, well, there's virtually no chance it won't pass. Well, you know, we've seen votes before that were pretty close. And when things don't pass, there isn't money available for certain
you know, whatever maintenance or things that need to be done around town, that presents a problem. So I just don't get this. We spent this whole morning talking about this issue. Obviously, there's so much confusion about why, and just from what I'm hearing, why this is even necessary. You know, if we can't trust, again, if we can't trust our select board to appropriate funds the right way, then they just need to be voted out of office. It's really that simple. I'm not seeing any warrant article for that. And that sounds like what the problem is. Thank you.
Do we have any other public comment as far as the operating budget? Yes, sir.
Joe Dash, what did you do for Rose? Pretty interesting conversation. And I think we all have that goal that everybody agrees to. But this procedural issue, how does that get involved? I can see it being a big problem going forward in knowing the town. But is there a vote that takes place in this meeting? I'm kind of new to adventure politics here, but you know, how do we get to the point that things that are not capital items are part of the operating budget, and what was proposed by the budget committee in terms of taking something out and putting it in the warrant article is something that should not be done, not only for this one, but maybe for something else down the road.
This is a public hearing for public comment.
While there is no vote that the public can do with this, you're providing testimony, asking questions, and the like. What happens after this is that the budget committee still has another shot at making some changes to the operating budget. And so, which is why you've heard some people come up and encourage the budget committee to put the $250,000 back into the operating budget. So that's one. There still remains, it will be somewhat confusing to me, but perhaps not as much, given that this $250,000 is back. But that is, the warrant article exists. None of us can touch it. It's a legally presented petition warrant article. So we will have to act upon it at town meeting. So one scenario that might happen is normally a board member gets up after each petition article, you know, the moderator recognizes one of us. And so what I suspect would happen if the $250,000 is put back into the operating budget today is that the board member would provide as much of this in as clear a way as possible and suggest to the body that we reduce that amendment to $1.
I would go along with a couple other people. In order to simplify the process, I would suggest to the budget committee that it would be a cleaner process for the town to let the committee run these kind of operating things and have the warrant article be after this group. I agree with that.
Thank you. Just for the sake of time, if you know, kind of limit any repeating.
Yes. My name is Paul Casal from Heritage Drive. And I'm looking at the 10-year spending plan. I think I'm crazy, but I'm looking at 2022, 2023, and 2024. The town budget is going to be going up by 5.5%, 6.4%, 4.57%. And on top of that, the long-term financing, which is only including the culvert, fire engine, and transfer station, 2017 warrant articles, you know, doesn't include any future projects. So looking at the future budget, I see a problem coming up that if you include all the future warrant articles, that the town budget could go up by over 10%.
Good question. So, and I'm glad somebody's looking at the 10-year projections. Thank you. I spent a lot of time on that. So, the goal for the budget, the goal for the board this year is to present a budget that is in 3.2% overall increase. And by overall, I mean the sum and resolution of the operating budget, the capital expenditure reserve budget of warrant articles, as well as our anticipated revenue. Because you can't, when you're talking about tax rates and the increase that you might see in your bill, you can't look at just one term. You have to look at all of the terms. And so we managed this year to have an estimated tax decrease. I would just say well, because it's small enough. So now, and you'll see that for the next 2 or 3 years, we're sort of about 2.1%, which gives me, as a budget person, the ability to say, okay, that's great. I look at that and I say, we could probably get that down to below 2, because there's time. So that those projections are just, first of all, an inflationary figure just added right across the top of the operating budget, 2%. An inflationary figure of 1% on the revenue. And then our debt repayment schedule. And so what, for me, and I'm going to speak just for myself as a board member, not the whole board, I was happy for the next 2 to 3 years because I'm looking at that and say, okay, great. We can bring that to within 2, and maybe even less, but certainly within 2. And you're right, outlook it starts to look a little weird, but that represents things on the capital improvement project plan. That's largely the driver for that. And so there's plenty of time for the capital improvement project plan committee to get together, look at that, maybe stretch some things out. We've already heard from our road agent that the next truck that needs to be replaced does not have to be as expensive as the one we currently have. So there are opportunities as we work on that to say, look, looking forward, what can we move out? What can we reduce? What can this and that? So I'm not so worried about that. It is interesting, and it's helpful to know. It means we are going to have to do some work. You know, next year we'll take a look at that again and see if we can stretch out the 2% to the next 2 or 3 years. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes, but thinking to myself, as I voted for last year's warrant articles, and I'm saying to myself this year, geez, did we really have to spend all that money for the transfer station? Did we always, did we have to spend all that money for the fire engine? Couldn't we have bought a standard truck instead of a special one? So I'm thinking about the future, and we all make mistakes, and I'm thinking to myself, geez, did I vote correctly on those items? To learn about the next item. Because we all, we can always look back and say, I should have done it that way or, this way. What matters is what you do now and in the future.
Right, which is why we think it's a good idea to have a projection so we can look at that and have conversations like this. I would encourage you, we're always looking for people to serve on the capital improvement budget plan. We will contact you. If you'd like to serve on that and help us out with that, it would be a great thing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
that own 44 Rollins Road. We just talked about 2% across the board. What's the librarian getting for a raise? 12%? That's not 2%.
We're not going to have a banter back and forth. I think the answer is in the budget. I think it's clear in the budget what the librarian's increase
is. I believe the budget committee was supposed to get a follow-up on why it went to 12%.
As a budget committee, we can discuss that after the meeting.
Just the warrants that have appropriations associated with them. So if you've gotten a piece of paper, the document that I'm back, you'll see that there are some gaps in the number, and that's because those warrants in between don't have appropriated amounts, and so they're not relevant to this particular meeting. All right, so the first item is the service truck for the highway department. We brought this up last year, and there was a lot of discussion at town meeting, and we never executed the plan. Our road agent, we asked our road agent to close to the end of the year, and because we were concerned about some of our larger capital projects. And by that time, he was no longer with us. We hired a new road agent. And so I was talking with our new road agent, but he did recommend that we go forward with a service truck, that it is economically makes more sense for some of the smaller jobs around town to not use that Ford F-50 that we have. He would like to outfit it, however, with the utility box, with plow. In the past, we usually had at least one occasion, sometimes two, where one of our trucks is out of commission for a snowstorm, and we have to contract or commit or someone else to do the road plow to the tune of like a couple or $3,000. And so that is the rationale. Our road agent is here too. Well, I would like to ask the question, and Michelle thinks it's appropriate for him to answer. It is recommended by the board, and it is coming out of the capital improvement project plan, so there's no impact on taxation. It's going to be taxation. It will be funded by the also for the highway department is a proposal to buy a roadside mowing attachment from the CIP, so again, no impact on the 2018 tax rate. We currently contract out the service. We had a budget of $3,000. Last year, we were unable to find somebody to do that amount, and we were up to four, maybe a little bit more than that, to contract it out. It never happened because that person's equipment broke, and so we ended up not getting any roadside mowing. With this attachment, we will be able to save whatever they would pay us for outside contracted fee. Recommended by the board. And one of the things that the budget committee will do after this public hearing is also these, and just as the board has either recommended or not recommended, the budget committee will either recommend or not recommend all of these reforms. So the third capital purchase item is for a police cruiser for the Rochester Police Department. This is a biennial request, comes up every other year. And the money, just as with the truck, is for both the purchase and the outfit. So the police will have to do detail work, the transfer radios, they do whatever else police begin to do to get the police ready for the manual. All right, those are the purchases, and they are all funded from the capital improvement reserve fund. And now we're going to replenish some of our reserve funds. This is what the next set of warrants is about. First is that very same capital improvement reserve fund. We're asking for $178,200 to say, why is it all up to the slavery numbers, that's what came out when we looked at the capital improvement plan for 2018. So it's $178,200. The plan is available on the website. It's hard to print, it's big, but I encourage you to take a look at it. In 2017, so the end of the year that just ended, the fund balance for that fund was $250,000. We're going to increase that about $80,000 as a net, because we're asking for $99,000 to fund those purchases I just talked about. We're putting in $178,200, so we're going to net increase to that CIP budget, plus $80,000. We have a culvert repair replacement fund. This has been to help us with some of these large culvert projects. The smaller culvert projects come out of maintenance, our road maintenance. These big ones, we have to sort of plan for and save for in last year's case, borrow money for. So we did not ask for a request to this fund in 2017. There was a balance in there. We used that we completely wiped out that balance in order to have a culvert repair project. So that project was funded largely by borrowed funds from the USDA, but also to up to $50,000 by the money that was remaining in this fund. What are we going to do now with the culvert repair replacement fund? Our goal are the two culverts on Sligo Road that we're not sure exactly what we're going to do, but we know they're both problematic. The Conservation Land Trust Capital Reserve Fund. So we're asking you to put $10,000 into that reserve fund. However, there's no impact on the tax rate for this one because the money will be transferred from the land use change tax fund. The article is a little complicated. It says if there isn't any money in here, it's going to come from fund balance, blah, blah, blah. But I'm here to tell you there is money in the LUCT fund. And so that $10,000, this is approved, will come from the LUCT fund into the Conservation and Trust Fund. At the end of 2017, the balance in that fund is $135,538. The land surveys, this is also something we see every year. This request to spend money if the situation arises. So we're requesting to spend $5,000 from one of our reserve funds, from the Conservation Land Trust Capital Reserve Fund, in order to fund land surveys and other associated expenses regarding conservation land stuff. So if there's a landowner who's thinking about maybe providing a conservation easement or something like that, and want some help from the town for a survey or something like that, this gives us the authority to spend up to $5,000 for that. If we don't spend it, it stays in the reserve fund, and it's not used for anything else. This is the road resurfacing petition warrant article. We've already said a few things about it, so this is what it is. It's not the kind of stuff here. This is another petition warrant article. We have to look at it today, but it also has a very small, but nonetheless has an appropriation associated with it. So we have a newly formed historic committee, which is really wonderful to have, and they are requesting to establish a fund within the town's trust funds. We have trustees of the trust funds that manage and oversee all of our reserve funds. And they're requesting to establish a federal trust fund. But they're asking for a little bit more than that. So they want to set up the fund, and then they want to transfer $350, or appropriate $350 from fund balance to seed that new special fund. And the $350 represents more or less the amount of revenue that they brought in 2017, from donations, from sale of some items, and the like. And so they're asking to transfer that into this expendable trust fund. They were also asking that the select board be agents of the fund. So if in 2018 they want to spend $125 on something that seems historical and appropriate to their charge, they will come to the board and say, can we have $125 from our expendable trust fund to do whatever it is? And the board would be able to say yes or no. We could say yes. And then that's it for the warrants, but we just want you to keep in mind that if there is no proposal for a new police station in this year's budget,
None of us have forgotten it. We appointed a special committee during 2017 to look at sites, to look at the police station, what that means to us. And we're not bringing forward a proposal, but the committee did ask us if we would submit a request for proposal, an RFP, just to get an idea of cost. And we did do that in November, I believe. And the cost came back about 1.1 to 1.3 million in that range, using the Silver Street site. So it was a total package as far as site development, landscaping, and everything. But that was the figure. Now, because, you know, the board is not going to make that decision. That is definitely a town-level decision to make about the police station. We don't have it in our projections because we don't know what the town feels about this. We don't know where it might go, but it, there is money for a police station in the CIP. It's not sufficient to fund a brand new $1.1 million, but if you're thinking about, oh my God, you know, we need to come up with $1.1 million, it won't be quite that bad because we are every year putting money in the CIP for a police station.
We would take public comment at this time on the warrant article. I have a bunch of questions, so I guess I'll start with warrant article 6. We appropriated money in 2017 for the highway department gym that was destroyed. What happened to those funds? Are they still available? Is this money that we'll request on top of that, or is that part of the savings?
So the money to fund, I think it was a $20,000 request. That money was in the capital improvement plan reserve fund. It's called the state reserve fund. And we didn't spend it, so it stays in the CIP. So that was part of whatever the balance was that I mentioned earlier in the SIP fund, that $20,000 part of that balance. So this is like erasing. Didn't happen, erasing out of your mind. It's a brand new request, starts from scratch. It's not going to be added to with another $20,000. This request stands on its own.
And this may be a question for the board to consider.
This, but will there be
a need for additional space
for
renovations at the highway department, or is there space for it?
I believe I can answer that because we asked that very question for road agent last year. Is there space for the highway department?
Okay. I'll move on to my next question.
Okay.
Is there a need for additional space for buying a mower, will we see the savings in the short term, long term? And is there a vehicle for it to go on? And what is the liability to the town if it doesn't pass?
All right, so that the $12,000 estimate is a mower attachment that goes on either the Bobcat or the Volvo. So yes, it can fit on our equipment. We have while we've been budgeting $3,000, we didn't have anybody to do $3,000 last year. So the cost is closer to four, maybe a little bit more. So in 3 years, we will save the mowing attachment. As far as liability, there's no difference. You know, there's no difference. If we talk about if we destroy someone's property, it's our, whatever the problem is, I don't know that it is a problem because I'm not a lawyer. It would be the same whether we had a contractor or did it ourselves.
For the police cruiser, do we know if it's going to be another SUV or?
Yes.
For the culvert repair, more article, what is the amount we're looking for the life of our life?
Well, we don't know. So is it going to be more than 10? Yes. So one of the things we have to do is come up with some engineering solutions and get some input from the town residents, because in particular, the one that's now a one-lane road, it's a beautiful stone culvert that
got something sitting for it there. And so while it's easy to say, this plan is not us, but put this on the bridge program, the state's bridge program, state would pay 80% of replacing it, the town would pay 20%, that would be fine. But we have to bring it to the town and see if there are, what the town feels about replacing some culverts. And we're also not sure what the series is for the other culverts. Two culverts at the time, top of another, it's kind of a weird thing, so I'm not sure what the series
is. Is the select board looking to put any money aside for an emergency repair that we had a few years ago, where we had to put a lot of money here in town?
Well, what we are trying to do now is plan. And so, could an emergency always happen anywhere at any time? Yeah, because we don't control Mother Nature or people or anything like that. But we're not anticipating anything in the next 3 to 5 years.
And for Article 11 and 12, the reserve fund and the land survey, is there an optimal amount that the select board would like to see in those accounts? The conservation land trust capital reserve fund and the land survey and related expenses.
All right, so the first one is the request to put money in the reserve fund. We customarily ask for $10,000. I'll just leave it at that. The other one is not a reserve fund. The land survey is just a potential expense that can be funded by the reserve fund that we just talked about. If, just like the truck we can buy, if no one comes to us, there's no action that the board might take that we can legitimately pay for with this warrant, if nothing like that happens, we don't spend $5,000, it stays with $3,000 or whatever, it stays entirely within the conservation land trust.
And then my last comment is that the historical committee has talked about fundraising, and by establishing a fund, this would allow us to raise those funds instead of coming to the town to request funds to do historical preservation and work around the historical.
Thank you.
Any questions? None at all. I'll get to the interesting part. I have Ray, Frank, Mike, Gail. Say that. Any questions? I'm not going to answer any questions. These people would answer all questions. All right, water. Well, it's $295,000 this year. I want Ray trying to get out and explain the water to us and what are the projects ahead and what are we going to do about the off of land. What are we moving into the rest? Can you do that, Paul? No, no budget. Oh, we don't want to do the what the plan is to do. Okay. Okay. Any questions on water? I could say that we're going to have some rate increases this year, next year. Can I say that?
Don't know.
No,
we don't know yet.
We don't know yet. Okay. Any questions on soil? 301,903. Budget. Any questions? That's too easy. That's too easy. It's a shame. All right. Thank you.
Okay. Any other business that would come before the committee today? Hearing none, we'll close the public hearing. And we will be, yes, we have a public meeting and you're welcome to stay directly after a restroom break. But you are not to announce the change.
He's an Orient, yeah. No, my other son.